Hey everybody, it is Scott the Steehnroller Steen with winnersandwiners.com coming to you with the one and only Steehnroller free play of the day. As always, if you're having fun, making a little money, digging what we're doing, we'd appreciate the thumbs up. Give everybody a chance to smash that thumb here right at the beginning. Get ready, hit ready. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Smash. Beautifully done. Thanks very much. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. Don't forget to check out me and Rye Shells. We do our radio show every day. Put it up in podcast form to beat the crowds. So if you want to check out what we're thinking early, you can certainly head over to Spotify, Google Play, or Anchor, as well as your favorite podcast platform, and download that. We always appreciate the effort. Makes us look good for the boss. So thanks very much for listening. And of course, we want to know what you're playing. What the hell? You guys are some great handicappers out there. A lot of you had really good days yesterday. So put those plays in the comment section. You get them right, we'll give you the shout out. You get enough of them right, and you could be the capper of the day. All right, guys. Well, with that being said, take a look at yesterday's action. We did have the Kansas City Royals plus 152. I don't know if y'all knew this or not. Everybody should write this down. Sal Perez, pretty good baseball player. Absolutely in fuego right now as he cranked a grand slam that made the difference there in the sixth or seventh inning. So nicely done. Royals bullpen hangs on for a 6-4 win. Kansas City taking care of business better than 3-2. So that's how I did for the day. And let's take a look and see what we've got cooked up for today. I've got one NFL play on my premium plays. Nothing else I really liked. You know, Scott and I talked about he likes the Eagles getting the points over the Jets. I don't want any part of those teams. I don't want any part of Detroit. I don't know what's going on with Indianapolis and in their quarterback situation. And Pittsburgh without Roethlisberger or Mason Rudolph scares the shit out of me, but I don't want any part of the Panthers. So there you go. That's kind of my feelings on the football for today. We'll have some college, though. Well, we've got a college football game for you tomorrow, almost promise. But in the meantime, we're going to take a look at two pretty fair baseball teams, two division leaders, as the San Francisco Giants travel to Hotlanta, Coca-Cola City, to take on the Braves. Braves, home favorite here, minus 125. What? Over the best team in baseball? Yeah, that's right. Kevin Gausman goes for the Giants against, Max Fried for the Atlanta Braves. Bang, bang, Maxwell's silver hammer has been coming down lately. Now, if you listen to our radio show, we are constantly harping about how the Giants are undervalued almost each and every day. We recommended them all 3 days against the Mets, and they took care of business. They're the best team in baseball. I don't know if I mentioned that, but they are getting absolutely no respect. And again, like I said, they're actually underdogs in this one. So what gives? Well, here's the deal. It's Maxwell and his silver hammer. He has been dealing lately. 1.06 ERA, 0.85 whip in his last five. And the last time out, now a four-hit complete game shutout over the Orioles. Now, that was before the Orioles found their offensive mojo. And before running into the Yankees, the Braves as a team were playing extremely good baseball, winning 9 straight and 16 of their last 18 before they dropped 2 in a row. Short little two-game series to the Pinstripers. Now for the Giants, they're still doing their thing, still keeping that lead on the Dodgers. They've won 5 straight, 8 of their last 10. Now the difference for me in this one is Kevin Gausman. He once was a Cy Young candidate back at when DeGrom went down. His name was kind of at the top of the list, but he's been leaking a little oil lately. 5.17 ERA, 1.69 whip in his last 7. And he's not good over that stretch. Now, the weird thing is the Giants have gone 5-2, mainly due to the fact their offense putting up 6 runs per game. Well, that'll certainly help you out. By the way, Gausman has not been having a hard time finding the plate. He's given up 16 walks in that stretch over just 31 in the third innings. You're giving up better than a walk every other inning. That ain't good, kids. I don't think the Giants are going to get to their 6 runs per game like they have been against Max Fried. San Francisco has the better pen, but I think the absolute most we're going to see out of the pen for the Atlanta Braves. Going to be three innings and possibly less. It's been seven starts since Max Fried's gone less than six. I like our chances here. Braves, good price. Let's take care of business. Atlanta Braves minus the 125. At the end of that one, you guys can join me as we pick up our winning tickets and head back to the window. All right, guys, as always, know how I did. Let's see how y'all did. First of all, we'll talk about a couple of retros. Maurice Walker hit a 17-teamer yesterday. What's that pay, you wonder? About 25-1. Not bad at all. Here's the great sweat. The last leg was the San Diego team total under 3.5. Holy shnikes. You know, those games are the best when you hit them, because, you know, we had the same thing. We had the Dodgers on the premium yesterday, and every bottom of the inning, we had to sweat that they were going to score a goddamn run. So congratulations, Maurice. That must have been a blast when you hit it. Way to go. And I talk about you guys helping each other out. Great example of it today. Mem and Funderburk tailed Ted Piano, the parlay master. All he did was pick up a little four-team parlay plus 922. Memon says, hey, Ted, you ever get down to Atlanta? The varsity's on me. All the dogs you can eat, brother. What do you have? Nicely done. Ted, thanks for putting that up there. Memon, way to go, brother. All right. So as far as the rest of you go, Jeremy Wesley going 3-2 plus 100. Bazanster, perfect day, 4-0 plus 400. Steve the Godfather go down 2-1 plus 90. R. Rivera, 9-1-1, 2-1 plus 90. Barry goes 3-1 plus 200. Doc Brown, the doctor is in the money, going 5-0 plus 500. Clint Richardson, 3-0 plus 452 as he rode the Royals with us. Jan Dudley, 1-0 plus 500. Dodgers first five. Envy Ups, 1-0 plus 500. Had Seattle first five before Sal Perez caught fire. But your capper of the day, he put just one play out there. And by golly, this young fella tailed us, and it worked out okay. It's Benito Quevedo going 1-0 plus 760. He rode that all the way to victory. Congratulations, Benito. It's been a while, brother. Good to have you back in the saddle, because you are the capper of the day. Well done to you. Well done to the rest of you. Nice profit there for a Thursday, guys. A lot of guys were on the Royals. That was a beautiful play. Well done indeed. So let's go out there, keep it rolling right into the weekend. You guys have a great day. Good luck on all your plays. Hope every one of those tickets in your pocket turns into cash money when you head back to the window. You guys take care. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.